Hello and welcome to Business Matters, a program produced by the Middlesex West Chamber of Commerce in conjunction with Acton TV. I'm your host, Jonathan Kerr, the Executive Director of the Middlesex West Chamber of Commerce. Business Matters is a program which features chamber members and highlights information important to businesses in Middlesex community. And here today, I'm with Travis Miner of Open Door Education. How do you do today?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm appreciating the warmer weather we had this week.
Me too.
We'll see how that goes.
Well, it lasts.
Coming up, yeah, exactly, in the next couple of weeks. But Open Door Education, what does that do? What do we do here?
So Open Door is a small tutoring and testing firm, and in short, we help students succeed. We work with students from grade 6 up through seniors in high school and some adult learners, helping them either in the classroom to get ready for tests, to understand content, to be better organized. And then also we help them with the test prep side of things. So if they're taking the SAT, the ACT, SSAT, ISEE, the whole batch of tests that are out there can be awfully intimidating and challenging, and we help students to navigate those.
Oh, okay. And so how did you end up starting the organization then?
So I started tutoring out of the back room of the house that my wife and I live in here in Acton, and slowly over time started to build that practice. And then I partnered with Matt McNicholas and Aaron Webb, who were running a really similar business over in Boxborough, and we were very like-minded, and we had similar goals, and most importantly, similar values. We partnered up in, 2013, and that's when we moved into our first location in Acton Center. Okay. And we've started growing the team from there.
Okay, so and now you have a second location that just opened up, and
yeah,
that's in Concord, right?
We just opened a location in Concord Center that we are super excited about. For a number of reasons, the opportunity to grow is exciting, and also convenience. One of the things that's really important about the work that we do is that we're engaging with students and their curriculum, which means it's really important that we know and understand the context that they're coming from and are able to engage with their experience at a particular school. So having a location in Acton puts us in a good position to really help students who are coming from AB. And in Concord Center, we can better serve students in Concord and surrounding towns. And also it means people don't have to deal with the rotary at 5 o'clock, which is the worst.
Yeah, no question there. So do you work more with the executive function aspects and preparation and study habits and that sort of stuff? Or are you actually, you know, more directly related to a subject as far as tutoring? You know, or those kind of things? Or is it a combination?
Great question. The core of our work deals with the content, the student's comprehension, and it may mean, for example, in math, helping a student with a topic that's been challenging, they need to look at it from a different angle and also have the opportunity to get some direct feedback as they're doing problems and have that real one-on-one support as they're building their understanding of that concept. On the test prep side, formulating strategy, providing appropriate practice, and also in many cases going back and teaching how do commas work and when do you use a semicolon and things like that.
Right.
Executive function is something that we help students with as part of a larger process, and if a student is specifically struggling with executive functioning, then we generally refer them to someone in our network who's specifically works with students on that.
Okay, so it sounds like you have a lot of opportunities there for quite a wide range. I mean, you've said who, you know, is part of Open Door as far as running the organization, and you mentioned sixth grade through high school and then some adult as well. Can you tell me a little more about that? Like, how would an adult fit into this, you know, as far as what they're getting out of it, that sort of thing?
Absolutely. So in many cases, it's somebody who might be applying for graduate school and needs to take the LSAT or the GRE, so sort of returning to standardized testing after many years of not having to deal with it. People who are at different places in their lives, that makes up a relatively small portion of our business. It's largely high school. And one of the things that allows us to really cover the range from sixth grade through 12th grade in terms of the actual content in the curriculum is the really fantastic team that we have. Our tutors have really wonderfully diverse backgrounds from former principals, former scientists, some tutors who have recently graduated from or are in graduate school. Mm-hmm. And it allows us to find the right pairing, because really that's the most important part.
Right.
The students working with someone they know, like, and trust throughout mm-hmm. this process. And by working with someone who knows the content and also someone they connect with on a personal level, I think we're able to have a really great impact. And that having a team that allows us to find the right fit for each student is one of the most important parts of how we do business.
Right. So, yeah, I mean, a lot of it obviously centers around that sixth, you know, high school age aspect and all that. What do parents need to know about testing, that sort of stuff? You know?
I'm glad you asked, because there is so much misinformation out there. There are so many anecdotes from students and teachers and parents who many are giving really good advice from 5 years ago,
right,
because the landscape has changed quite a bit recently. And one of the biggest decisions families are now making when it comes to college admissions, should the student take the SAT or the ACT? And it's really important for families to know that in at least for United States schools, schools that require testing will accept either the SAT or the ACT.
Mm-hmm.
And so families don't need to worry about which test should I take for this university.
Okay.
Instead, it is purely a matter of which test is a better fit for this particular student, and focusing on doing one test, doing it as well as possible, as opposed to trying to juggle two tests simultaneously.
Right.
One of our goals is to, first and foremost, help students and families choose the right test. And then once they've chosen the right test, one of the most important things we do is help students to get the scores that they need and to be done with testing as soon as possible, because we are not advocates for the standardized tests themselves, but instead seek to help students get through this process,
right,
get what they need out of it, and move on to the other parts of college admissions that are exciting and fun and personal.
Right. Yep.
So the most important thing for families to know up front, they can take either test.
Mm-hmm.
It's worth doing the due diligence to determine which test is the best fit, and then do one thing, do it well, and also recognize that students are at really different places in terms of maturity when it comes to, I mean, junior year to senior year.
Right.
The student who comes in on day one may feel like an entirely different person than that student who in the fall of senior year is sending off their applications. And that may mean that a student takes a test once early on to get some baseline, to have had that experience and normalize it a little bit. And then they take a long break and come back for one last test,
right,
in the fall of senior year, when they may find that being more mature, being invested in the process in a different way, and being ready to do the work for themselves really sets them up for success.
Right. Part of it is as a reality hits them heading into adulthood.
Absolutely.
How much of a difference that can make. But it's interesting you mentioned that, because I, you know, just thinking in my own life how much the SAT is, you know, changed even recently. I mean, you know, I ran a youth center for a while, and you'd hear a lot about this.
Totally.
And, you know, it went from just these simple, you know, not simple being relative, but, you know, math and English, and then all of a sudden it was an essay involved, and it was kind of an open-end essay, and now it sounds like it's gone back to, you know, they kind of give you a subject to write about, and it just seems to be perpetually changing. And then with colleges being more open to the ACTs, is that it, the ACTs?
The ACTs,
okay.
Yes.
Yeah, and, you know, back when I was doing that in the 80s, nobody knew what that was. There were like, you know, six colleges or something. Now it sounds like, you know, it's, you can go either direction on that.
And that's a big change. And a lot of parents find it difficult to first accept that you really could do just this test and have all of the same options available as if you took the SAT or took both of them.
Wow. All right. So how does Open Door help families navigate this kind of testing and everything else? It sounds like you're mentoring them as much as anything about, you know, whether to do this one or not. You know, is, you know, do you have a process for that, or is it really just building the relationship and getting to know the student and then figuring it out from there? Or?
It's for many families, it's as with all things in personalized work, it varies from case to case. But a very typical process for a family would be that they would come in for an initial diagnostic test. And in many cases, the student would take a diagnostic SAT and ACT. And we offer those for free at our office pretty much every Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, okay.
A student would come in, take the test. Within about 3 or 4 days, they'll get a full report that goes over not only what happened score-wise, but what types of questions were toughest for them, so that then we can sit down with the family, hold the results of the two tests side by side, and help them to make an informed decision that's based in part on the data that we have from the test. And also, and this is really important, we're engaging the student in the conversation. Mm-hmm. What was their experience like with this test? It may be that they scored a little higher on the ACT, but the time pressure in the reading section was really unpleasant for them.
Mm.
That's important information, and that guides our choice as well. Once we've decided which test to take, then it's a matter of saying, what test date are we shooting for? And backwards from there,
right,
when's
okay.
going to be the right time to start? And usually a student would then be paired with one of our tutors and work with that one person who would guide them through the entirety of the process from their first session right up through test day. Along the way, they'd take a practice test or two to be able to sort of road test the strategies that we're working on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's important to us that we're looking at data with the student as we go to say what's working, what's not, and helping them to really hone in on the work that they can do that will make the biggest difference, not just busy work, but the stuff that will really challenge and push them.
Wow. I mean, it sounds great. It sounds like a much more of a relationship going on there than just, you know, the coming in and getting stuck at a desk, you know, with one person that says, now here's how you do math and, you know, that sort of thing. There's definitely a lot more, you know, and certainly I think for youth that helps with their comfort levels and everything else, and that I'm sure trickles down to how they perform in a test. So.
Absolutely.
Right. So besides the new location, anything new you want to tell us about? And you know,
one thing that we're really excited about incorporating more and more into our practice mm-hmm. is recognizing the experience of taking the test, and that a student can know all of the content on the test. They can do a number of practice tests, but sometimes they'll have this experience of sitting in the testing center and all of a sudden it hits them. This is real. Like, this is the
right.
actual test that we've been talking about and thinking about for ages, and here it is. And one of the things that we're doing is working with students to provide some guidance around little exercises they can do, often grounded in mindfulness, to center themselves, to acknowledge this is how I'm feeling in this moment, and to have something to actively do about it, that a student knows, if and when I start to feel this way on test day, this is how I respond, so that then they can settle in, do the work, and also feel that they've gained a tool that will help them in stressful situations going forward. So that's something we're really excited to integrate more and more into our work. We're starting to do a free night before the SAT yoga class to like de-stress and
nice.
Get kids in the right state of mind, and really just acknowledge that it's not a fun process. It's a standardized test, and it can be a really dehumanizing experience.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to make sure that we're recognizing what it's like for the student and helping them to be equipped both for the test and for the experience of being a test taker.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
It's great to learn all about open door education. And we'll be back after a short break.